Variables let you contain specific values that can be reused throughout your site. Change one variable, it changes everywhere it's being used. Now, how is that different from a class? Here we have three classes, one for button, one for card, and one for our image. If we make a background color change on the button class, it only affects the elements with the button class applied. On the other hand, with variables, if we have a color variable applied to these classes, when we make a change on the variable, it's affected everywhere where that variable is being used. Now, why is this so important? If you have a large site and your client asks you to change, for example, their brand color, and that color value is applied to multiple different classes all over your site, instead of going in and updating each class one by one, with variables, you'll just update that one brand color and your whole site is updated. Variables give you the power and the control to make global changes to specific variables quickly, all while being consistent and efficient. So, let's see how to use variables in the Webflow Designer. First, we'll create a variable. We'll show how to apply it to elements on our site. We'll edit it to see the real magic in action. We'll show how to manage and group our variables. We'll unlink a variable. And finally, we'll show how to delete one. Let's dive right in and create a new variable. We're in the Webflow Designer, but let's head over to the Variables panel. And we can see that we already have a few. But we want to create a new one. We can do that up here, but for this one, let's go back to the canvas. And over here, there are a lot of different elements, and some with different classes applied to them. So, with this card selected, we can see here in the Style panel, we already have the background color set. But we're here to make this a variable. So, if I hover over and click in, we can go in and create a new variable. Let's name it Brand, and we'll save it. Now, if we navigate to our Variables panel, we can see it's added there, along with our other variables. But that's creating a new variable. Let's move on and use it. Let's apply it throughout our site. So, with that color variable we created before, now I want to use that same color on multiple elements that have different classes. But with this text selected, let's navigate to the Style panel. We'll scroll down to find our text color. Once we're there, we'll hover over and click in to select the color variable we just created. That's it. But let's do another one. Here, we have this hero heading title and it has a gradient clip to the text. If we go into our gradient and with this first stop selected, we can, again, hover over and click to choose our primary color variable. And for our second stop here, let's choose the one we created earlier, our brand color. There we go. Now we have two color variables working together in this gradient. That's using our variable. Let's move on to editing. This is where it gets really interesting because with anything that has our brand color variable applied, if we go in and start changing that color variable, the color changes everywhere where that variable is used. The background color, the text color, and that one gradient stop, even though they're all using different classes. That's editing a variable in the Style panel. Let's move to Manage. Let's organize the variable we created earlier. In our Variables panel, we can see we already have a group for color. So, to put my brand color variable in this color section, we'll click on the name and we'll want to rename this to color/brand. Press Enter, and just like that, our brand color variable is grouped inside the color section. Basically, when grouping your variables, you want to rename your variable to the following format: group name slash variable name. But that's managing our variables in the Variables panel. Let's keep going and move to unlinking. If we don't want a class to have a variable applied to it anymore, we need to unlink it. So with this text selected, we'll go to our brand color variable, click to go in, and we'll unlink it. Now, if we go in and change that color, it only affects this class. But keep in mind, we didn't delete this variable. We simply unlinked it from this class on the font color. To delete a variable, this is our last step, by the way, let's go back into our Variables panel. Hover over the variable we no longer need, click our settings here, and we'll delete that variable. And that's it. We've deleted that variable from our site. However, if that variable was used anywhere else on your site, that value from that variable you just deleted, it stays wherever that variable was used. And you can see over here in the Style panel that there was a variable applied here that was deleted. From here, you got two options. You can either restore that variable, you can bring it back, or you can officially unlink it, so it's no longer connected to that variable. And that's what we'll do. Now, we can just affect color on this class however we want. There is so much more to variables than just color. There's size and fonts, where you can control your text and affect styling in a scaled, systematic way. But that's it for this lesson. We created a new variable. We applied it throughout our site. We edited our variable in the style panel, and we saw how it changed and updated our design everywhere. We managed our variables. We grouped it together to stay organized. We then unlinked a variable. And finally, we deleted a variable into oblivion. But that's a high-level overview of using variables in the Webflow Designer.